Like a Mardi Gras, everybody party all day, no work, all play, okay?
Taste of the Caribbean is an educational forum for food and beverage professionals throughout the Caribbean, but it's also a culinary competition, and it brings together, every year is different, but this year in 2018, we had 11 teams competing to be the best in the Caribbean. And it's very exciting. A lot of people focus on the competition, but taste is so much more than that. And I want you to get excited because you are competing with the best of your region. Are you excited?
Yes.
Show me. I know you're not gonna make this little noise in Caribbean 305. Come on now. All right, everybody get ready. We're gonna do it. Guess who's here in the 305? Make some noise. Teams come here that they normally don't have. There's no place else where all of these teams from all over the region can get together and see each other, learn from each other. There's such a camaraderie that's built around taste and around the love of food and a passion for their culture and where they're from. And you can see that even during the competition bits, that they're cheering each other on. There's a genuine brotherhood and sisterhood that comes out of taste that's beautiful to see. There are several competitions taking place. Some are group and some are individual. So we have the group competition that evaluates the team overall, which would be the team of around 5 to 6 chefs, including a junior chef and the bartender as well. But then you have the individual competitions, which there are several. There's the chef of the year, junior chef, you have bartender, you have beef, you have pastry. There are various categories where you as an individual can shine apart from your team, but then we also bring them together because it does take a team. If anyone has ever worked in a restaurant or worked in any capacity in the food and beverage industry, you know that teamwork absolutely makes the dream work. If you don't have a strong team, you have nothing. And those are all of them are stars. But the big heavy hitter, two big heavy hitter awards would be, or three, would be the group team competition, who the overall winner is, the bartender of the year and the chef of the year. It's the 25th year since we started Taste, but it isn't the 25th Taste because it hasn't been concurrent. There have been some years where we've taken a year off or two, but it has been 25 years since the first time we put Taste together in Jamaica, in Ocho Rios. That's where it started.
The Caribbean 305 is a real, 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 real big party. They put every team in a big, 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 big room at a Jungle Island, it's called, the venue. And we serve snacks that we normally eat at parties on all of the islands. Islands like Jamaica love to make the patties. Island like Curacao, I saw last year, they made it simple. They made a casbah. We always be having different team members Like myself, I have Dominican roots. I'm Dominican. Maria has Venezuelan roots. Shura has Bonairean roots. What we do is we come together. So if Maria makes a basis for the arepa, I'm sure makes a pisca salu from Bonaire, and I just make aguacate sauce that normally we do in Dominican. So we put everything together, and that's what fascinates people, because it brings country together around the Caribbean rail. Bahamas always come with their conchas and their hot sauces. Trinidad comes always with the roti and the real Tobago roots. So they're very good. Aruba's not here this year, but they also always bring their native stuff. And it's nice. You learn a lot from all the islands also, because so. Being a small island like Bonaire, sometimes we're limited to ingredients, and being a dry island, we're limited to ingredients that only get imported. But on the other islands that have more are bigger and they have more stuff getting in, yeah, you learn a lot from them too.
Judging works this way. What a lot of people don't realize, you're looking at the plates and you say, oh my God, this looks beautiful. For beautiful, you only get 10 points out of 100. And even competitors often don't realize until we make them aware of that, that 35% of the entire score happens in the kitchen. So that is the way you work in the kitchen. Do you work clean? Do you work organized? What amount of waste do you have? Do you have special culinary techniques? Are you on time? That is 35% of your total score. The other 65% are the tasting. So the tasting, it is 10 points, the presentation of the food. It is 10 points of do we use indigenous Caribbean ingredients? So you choose as a vegetable green beans, carrots, and celery. They are not Caribbean ingredients, but if you choose San Cristofine, mango, papaya, some other root vegetable that are common in the Caribbean, you're going to get a full score. If you don't choose to use them, I'm going to score you lower. And then the main score, 25%, is it's about the taste. And the taste is broken down into flavor, into texture. Do you have different textures within the dish? Is everything soft, or do you have a crunch? You have a soft, you have a sweet, you have a spice, you have a little bit of sour in there. So is it really a well-rounded plate? I'm now for 14 years a part of this competition, and I think the competition elevates itself every single year. And I would say about 5 years back, I saw a really big change when we really focus, when we give the competitors feedback and we talk about what can you do to make contemporary Caribbean cuisine. And that's the goal now, it is to create contemporary Caribbean cuisine. So what does that mean? It means cook with the ingredients of your mother, cook with the flavors of your grandmother, but put them on the plate in a presentation of a master chef.
You always hope to make the chance, but this is a tasting sport, a tasting competition. I think, to my taste, I think everything went just perfect. To the judges' taste, I don't know. But I do think we were very Caribbean. We were very good.
It went surprisingly well. Yeah, everything went well, and I was on time, we were all on time, and yeah, I'm really happy with it.
For me, it went good, started good though. I was on point, taste I was good also. I heard from the judges that some few things I need to work on for in the future, I would say. But they were surprised also with a lot of few dish of taste that I had actually. But they need to. Personally, for me, myself, I'm not a perfectionist, but I'm going along the way that I'm getting older, I'm feeling that it's getting stronger. I think they need to organize it also a little bit much better here, you know, because there was a few things that not, for me, it was not correct. But I'm not a person that's gonna be like going to the judge and asking and telling that you guys are doing this mistake and those kind of things. I just suck it up and just go further, you know? Because yeah, for me in a day, it's just a challenge. And yeah, if the judges can see also, even that the challenge is difficult and this guy is still relaxed, hey, you never know. They say this guy can win gold, you know?
I'm Calvin. I'm here for my third time, and I represent in Bonaire, and I am the bartender of the team. I'm very satisfied. I think we're gonna do very good, so I'm very happy. I think this is the year, so I'm very happy what we do and what we accomplish as a team this year.
I am here in Miami for the culinary team because I am competing for my individual to be the pastry chef of the year, but most importantly to win the team competition of the year. That's our main goal, get the goal for the team competition. My specialty is pastry. The idea came up since last year when we basically came back to Bonaire and I was like, okay, what am I gonna do next year? I wanted to do something different. I took a risk. I am not using a normal plate. I am using half a bottle of Ron Rincon. And I think that counts because you need to improve yourself and try to start new trends, you know? So that's why I went on that weird shape of a bottle plate. And then the flavors, I thought, well, if I'm doing a bottle, what people think is like, ooh, a message in a bottle that you found in the ocean with a love note or something like that. So I wanted to make a message in a bottle from Bonaire to the Caribbean. So I'm using a seaweed that you can find in all the south of the island. I'm using garlic that is a little weird to be in a dessert, but it goes very well with white chocolate. And yeah, just inspire myself with the bottom of the ocean. And I'm a hopeless romantic, so it is what it is.
This is my third year. I had for my first year, I would say, honestly, I came and I thought, you know, you're going to have fun, you're going to enjoy it, and maybe you're going to win, maybe you're not going to win, but still I had success in it for my first year, and that was 2 silver, 1 bronze. And what I say with perfection is I upgraded myself of saying to my boss, because my boss came also to Miami to support me, and I was telling him, I want gold, and he was laughing, you're going too fast, you know, relax, enjoy the moment, because yeah, you know, life is life. And then especially when I came the second year, and yeah, I managed to get that gold. And this year I thought, no, I want to go again for that same thing. Actually, I'm seeing every year that I'm getting older, that I'm starting to be a perfectionist. Perfection is everything, but I think I need to take like 2-3 steps and relax a little bit more, and then see the beauty of what I'm doing. Because in a way, when I was done, I was like, in a way, yeah, I didn't manage what I wanted to do. But when I came out and I put the plates on the table, and the reaction of people, that was really good. People were really loving it. So yeah, expectation, I did good. I did really good.
I have, besides the garlic and the seaweed, I have a honeycomb candy that looks like a coral. I have a caramelized white chocolate mousse, cardamom crumble, and churros. I think they're all good. Mine is just better because it's different. I am not saying that it's, I mean, I have not tried all the desserts. I don't know how they taste like. But you know, people eat with their eyes first. And my dessert attracts people because it's different. So I think that's kind of a step ahead I have from the rest. But hey, you never know. We're all waiting for the judges and we'll see what happens.
This year I took the gauntlet of Poppy. And this year I'm going to do the beef competition. The beef competition goes almost the same as like what I did last year. My plating idea is just from scrap up. I have my coach, coaches, and everybody was like my coach, and they gave me ideas, and I had Dinesh who helped me the most actually do. And we were just sitting together and we came with an idea like, I'm gonna do my plating like this, and the mystery is the protein, because I really don't know what I'm gonna get. I have 2 hours time to do competition. From 1 hour is only preparation, so I cannot cook. And yeah, let's say my way, I have 45 minutes to cook, where 10 minutes I have time to do my plating, and like 5 minutes to do my tiny, tiny taste plates.
This is my first time in the competition, the team of culinary. It's my first time too in Miami. And what I gotta do on the team is helping the team too to go for the gold medal. And I will do into the junior chef competition. What I expect for this competition is not really easy, that I know. And I'm really exciting, and I'm really nervous too at the same time. It's my first time, like I said. And I will go for all what I have and go for the medal. I guess it's a well tough competition. What the other teams gotta go do, I don't know exactly. I know they don't gotta lead it so easy for me. Yeah. But like I said, I will do my best. I will do the 100% of me to try to win this competition.
Cooking is always in motion. Cooking techniques change, flavors change. I think as a whole, the world is becoming a smaller place because everything is available at all times. And we really saw a big influence with Ferran Adrià, what he did in Spain with modernist cuisine. Then the big book comes out, modernist cuisine, the cooks, we, a chef, we are buying it. We want to use those techniques. So we always allow the competitors to bring in indigenous ingredients. So you bring in your herbs, you bring in your spices, you bring in some smoked herring, whatever is it that makes your food on your island special. And over the years, we also allowed them to bring in some ingredients that you need to do with molecular gastronomy, because we want to give them the best platform to create the best possible food. And we are seeing now chefs are cooking sous vide. We are seeing now a lot of foams, maybe too many foams. But we definitely see a lot of influences of modernist cuisine. And it has merit because it is the evolution of food. But what it always comes down to is you have to be brilliant with the basics and build upon that. Because if you present just a pretty plate with no flavor, remember, 25% is for flavor.
There is so much passion in the room and so much love for the region that I wish everybody could just see through, get a little glimpse of everything that happened. When we had a very rough year in 2017, both the islands that were affected and the islands that were not affected, because we were all grouped together under one banner. The Caribbean was hit. In reality, it was only a handful of the 34 islands that were hit, but everyone was impacted because there isn't a clear knowledge from the general public about where Barbados is, versus where Curaçao is, versus where. So it's, we are branded under one big umbrella. And once, the sooner we realize that and we work together to improve that brand, which is something that also CHTA is trying to do with an overall regional marketing initiative to build up the brand Caribbean so that we all are fortified through it. I think that the more people realize that we're in this more together than not, and if people only knew, I was there while we were getting hit in Miami at the same time, and while we were getting hit in Miami, we had mobilized so many people in all of the different islands. There were thousands of people working to make sure that the people that were hit in our island were okay and that they had what they needed. And if sometimes when you go through something so difficult, you feel like you're alone, trust me or not, there are so many people that are there loving you, supporting you, and working for you. And I think that's the one thing, is that we are stronger together. And I'm very proud to be Caribbean.
I've seen a lot of changes in quality, and I've seen changes in the professionalism of the chefs. I remember in the early years, I'm not sure if you know that, but I can't point the year out, but this competition started in Jamaica with a couple of grills on the beach. Chefs gathered from different islands. It was a competition and everybody got a grill, a piece of meat, and make the best grilled meat that you can. So it really evolved tremendously over time from those early, early beginnings to what it is today. But the chefs are evolving, and I believe that the judges have a big influence on that, because we give them, after every meal, we give them a critique about the dishes. And it's called a critique because we criticize them we point out things that they could do better, and the chefs are really taking those that feedback, and they're thinking about it when they're practicing. There's a lot of practice that goes into that prior to coming here. There's a lot of time. I know some of the teams, they practice for 6 months prior to coming here, once a week on their own time. There's a lot of personal commitment, and they're taking in consideration the feedback that we are providing, and therefore they're elevating the game, and everybody comes to play these days.
Basically, the bartender competition for the Taste of the Caribbean component was four basic individual competitions. There were four competitions, one being non-alcoholic, best non-alcoholic cocktail, best rum cocktail, also best vodka cocktail, and also the mystery bar competition as well. Mystery bar being the last competition, that's the probably the most funnest, arguably the most funnest part of the competition, where the competitors, the bartenders, didn't know exactly what they were getting. They didn't know what glass were they getting, they didn't know what spirits, what seasonings or sweeteners and so forth, and they basically had to make the best cocktail. This year, we also had a different component where we actually had something sponsored. Two actual ingredients by Angostura. One was the Amaro and also the orange bitters. Being a good bartender, a bartender that will win the gold medal, has to have consistency over the four competitions, which is basically 3 days of competitions. It's not only just what's good in the glass. It takes, we also judge on creativity, originality, visual appeal of the cocktail, presentation as far as how you're presenting yourself to the crowd, to the judges, and then also aroma, taste, balance of the cocktail. So tonight's winning bartender of the year is going to have a combination of all these items.
2 minutes remaining. 2 minutes.
Bonaire, are you ready?
Yes.
I present to you, I love Bonaire! Yes.
Not only a great presentation, great visual appeal of the cocktail, great presentation as far as how they're portraying what they're doing in the drink, and also of course the aroma taste balance of a cocktail. Can't be too sweet, can't be too bitter. Also, especially for the mystery bar component, making sure that you actually use the Amaro and also the orange bitters. So all those factors will actually present you with the bartender of the year for the Taste 2018.
I've stressed myself, as all the other team members know, most of the island will already know that this year we have stressed ourselves to the point of turning crazy and leaving the team, to be sincere. But I think the stress is needed. I think the new teammates, the old teammates need to get reminded that Bonaire is not a joke. We are taking the Bonairean flag. This is not a wiga, like we say. It's not a game. We have to represent Bonaire, and every time you have a lot of people counting on you, wishing you well, supporting you, like the big cast and the people that came out to the dinners, sponsorings, and the people who just say like, hey guys, here, I wish you the best, go for it, you know, are people that need to be, how you call it, recognized, and they need to be proud of, hey, Bonaire Culinary Team, you know, we are getting represented here at the States, amongst with other 15 to 20 islands that are coming in. And you can see that from big islands like Puerto Rico, lands like Belize are here, from the up islands like Bahamas, Barbados, are big teams. You can see teams here from 20 to 6, 16 to 20 members. And it's crazy, you think we're only 5 of us cooking. So we're taking on the world, but Bonaire's on our back. And we are getting better. And every time you see pictures from our old plates, you'll be like, oh, did we make that crappy plate and got gold? So we are getting better. The Caribbean region is getting better. And the Bonairean people are supporting us more. So it's a progress.
I love the Caribbean. I feel very fortunate to be associated with the CHTA. It's a great organization, and I love the people. It really is a collection of islands, and they are very different. The cultures are very different, and it's kind of like a smorgasbord of a culinary experience when you have them all in a room and everybody makes their own food and the different spices, and you smell it and you feel it, and but you also feel the friendship amongst the competitors, and it's just I'm grateful to be a part of it.
He was always focused.
For those who saw Facebook movies, we were there for gold. A bunch of us won that gold. They did fantastic, and there were some disappointments. But that's life. You win some, you learn some. For actually the whole team, it, however, seems to be an extra incentive to do compete for the team next year again. As everybody knows, the invitations will go out soon. Forever, who wants to go to Miami? There will be a local competition again, and this year chefs, some of them already said they want to compete for that spot again. Going to Miami is a big task, not only for the chefs and bartender on the team, but also for everybody involved. This year the team was almost twice as big as the year before. However, that does not mean we had it easier. We just made more work for ourselves. I'm very grateful that so many people are willing and able to put so much time in this Bonaire Culinary team. Of course, a huge thanks to all our sponsors, lots of new sponsors, and also the sponsors that have been supporting us for years and years. Please keep supporting us. We need you. We play hard, we need you hard. For this year, we already got some new plans. The team decided to challenge the coaches. So this year, the first time you will hear from us again, will be a coach and team challenge.